99% of the amateurs don't do this. What I'm going to show you today will lower your score. I've asked some PGA Tour players, if you can pick a golf superpower, what would it be? And most of them answered, the ability to make all the putts. I was like, these are the best golfers in the world, and they want what? And that's how important putting is. It takes up about 40% of your score. To eliminate three putting, you have to get the long putts close. And to eliminate posting big numbers, you have to be able to make these short putts. Today I'm going to show you three practices that tour pros do to help them make all the putts, which will lower your score. We're going to be focusing on distance and directional control. The drills I'm going to show you, I want you to stay on the same hole, but out on the putting green, it's really hard to do that, hog a hole with all the golfers around you. So I really prefer to practice in peace and quiet, right here in my living room, away from all the golfers, the sun, the snow, and the rain, and all of the above. The very first practice we're going to do is the directional control. This mat right here in Birdie Smart Plus shows you the direction the ball rolls on. So we're gonna just pay attention to the number that it shows on the display panel. Let me just show you for an example. If you're putting inside out path this way, boom, it says plus 5. So that means the ball is rolling about 5 degrees right at the target. And then let's say you strike it outside in, boom, it says minus 3. That means the ball is starting off to the left that much. So we're just going to not worry too much about where the ball ends up. We're just going to pay attention to this number. Make sure you start the ball online. All right, I have about 10 feet set up. Oh, I got 0. 2 in a row. Wow, not bad at this. I did usually get a lot of minus ones when I worked on it, so I think the practice did help for sure. Minus 1. So I want you to do this drill and focus only on the direction of the roll on the golf ball. And once you get better and better, it gets closer and closer to 0 and it becomes more consistent and you feel confident, then we can move on to practice number 2. Second practice is on the distance control. I've just changed the game mode, so I'm going to go ahead and pick 3 distances. Today I'll be picking a 4-footer, 10-footer, and 33-footer, but every session the distance could be different. Today I've picked my distances to work on because those are the length of the putts that I'm weak in. So, 4-footer first. When I was 13 years old, I played in this Junior World Day Pels Putting Championship. I won my age group 12 to 13 and also won the overall champion, which is under 18 boys and girls. In that tournament, if you missed a putt, you had to make sure it came to rest in the 3-foot half circle zone behind the hole cup. If you were short of it, you got penalized for it. And this game is actually exact the same way. So let's try 4-footer first. We'll do about 5 to 10 putts. Focus on the distance. Get the feel for it. Oh, a little long. So smaller swing size. Better. Even better. So you want to check out the distance on this display panel. Also shows you grouping of the golf balls you've hit. So you want these to get tighter and tighter as practice goes on. Stroke size and tempo will become a lot more consistent with repetition goes on. Perfect. Okay, I'm gonna move on to 10 feet because that was pretty good. My second distance, I'm going to do it about that big. Perfect. So now I'm working on the distance and I'm getting more confident with distance control at the moment. So I'm gonna go ahead and pay attention to the direction of the roll at the same time. So I'm working on the practice number one and two at the same time now, okay? So grouping is not bad, better than the previous one. Okay, now let's work on that long putt. We want to get him close. I love the fact that this game does not have a hole. So sometimes when you're practicing, you ram it in there. You're thinking, oh, I made it. It's good enough. But in reality, if there's no hole, you might have hit that ball like 10 feet past the hole. You really make sure you have to focus. Always checking direction of the roll and the grouping and the putting distance. So you want to spend about a good 10 minutes on each of the drills. You can spend more time if you want, because these games do actually help you to spend a lot of time on the mat having fun. Last but not the least, you always want to wrap up your practice as if you're playing for real. So every shot counts, right? When I used to play on tour, this was a very popular thing to do because Tiger Woods used to do it all the times. He used to always wrap up his putting practice by playing about 9 or 18 holes, meaning that was just on the putting green. Every hole was part 2 and you would play around and keep real score. So on this hole out game, my favorite thing is that it gives you undulation, so you get to work on your distance and direction and play every shot as if they count. I'll play just 9 holes to show you how I wrap up my putting practice. Ready? So now, par putt. Yes! Oh! Also, I set it up as no concede game, so that puts a lot more pressure on me because I have to make everything. Ooh, birdie. Ready? This feedback is really good. You now know that putting practice requires quality and quantity, but 99% of the amateurs don't do this. Today we talked about how to practice your distance control, directional control, and also wrapping it up by practicing like as if every single putt counts. This will help eliminate 3 putting and also eliminate posting big numbers, which will result in lowering your score. Let me know down below how you normally practice your putting and also your favorite part about today's lesson. In the next one, I'm going to show you how to get your tempo going beautifully. Thanks for golfing with me and see you in the next one. Mwah!